Hello, welcome to Arvind Singhitan in One Dimension, that is motion in a straight line. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about relative velocity. So in this lecture, I am going to discuss about the relative velocity. Without wasting time, let us start this topic and discuss relative velocity. So relative velocity is what? First of all, what is relative velocity? Relative velocity. As the name suggests, relative means in comparison with another. In comparison with another, a relative means in comparison with another. So, relative velocity of a moving body as compared to another, with comparison to another body. So, relative velocity of a body with respect to another, relative velocity of a body. Let A and B are two bodies. Let A and B are two bodies in motion. Then a relative velocity is defined as a relative velocity of body A. Velocity of body A observed by body B. Velocity of A observed by body B. Similarly, relative velocity of B, is the velocity of body observed by A. Is called relative velocity of B. With respect to A, and is denoted as VBA. Relative velocity of B with respect to A. And here the relative velocity of A is defined as the relative velocity of A observed by B called relative velocity of A with respect to B. This is called relative velocity of A with respect to B, denoted like this. So, velocity of A with respect to B. With respect to means B is an observer. Also, to make it more clear, we can define when A and B are in motion, then relative velocity of A can be described considering the velocity of A in which B appears as rest. That is, keeping B as rest, velocity of A is relative velocity of B. That is, assuming B as in rest, as in a rest, the velocity of A is said to be. Relative velocity of A with respect to B. Relative velocity of A with respect to B. With respect to B. Right? So it is denoted as I said that it is denoted as BAB. So that is velocity of A minus velocity of B. If body is moving in the direction, so keeping B as in rest, the velocity of B is to be taken negative. It means the respect to B, then B is to be taken in as negative. If both the body are moving, then their respective velocity as velocity with respect to ground. So we can say this is also defined as velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground, because bodies are moving in with respect to, their speeds are given with respect to ground only. So here the following some cases can be considered, like case first to explain this. Because relative velocity is described in one dimension and two dimension both, but we are discussing chapter of one dimension, so we will discuss first relative velocity in one dimension only, and thereafter when we will discuss motion in a plane, then we will also discuss the relative velocity once again for two dimension and three dimension as well. To explain this phenomena, let us consider some cases to explain it. Passage of relative velocity, right? So case first, if I am saying a car is moving on road, if a car is moving on the road with the speed of 20 meter per second, right? Car is, then what is the relative? Then relative velocity of car with respect to observer is what? Then relative velocity of car with respect to any stationary object on the ground. A stationary object or observer on the ground is 20 meter per second. Why it is so? For example, if car is moving in this direction, the speed is 20 meter per second. There is a car. And car is moving like, right? Car is moving in this direction 20 meter per second. So velocity of car with respect to observer, is nothing else. Relative velocity of car with respect to observer or any of the stationary object is velocity of car with respect to ground minus velocity of observer with respect to ground. Velocity of car with respect to ground is 20 meter per second, and since observer is a stationary with respect to ground, so velocity of observer with respect to ground is zero. So that is why it will remain 20 meter per second. So this is the first case. So any body moving on the ground, then there then observer, what observer is, their velocity is the same as their relative velocity. Relative velocity is same as the body moving. But case 2, let's see. When observer is moving with the speed of meter per second with respect to ground and car is moving. Car is moving with respect to with the speed of 20 meter per second with respect to ground. There is no need to say. So car is also moving here. This car is moving in this direction 20 meter per second. An observer is here. He is also moving with respect to 5 meter per second in same direction. In same direction. Same direction. Then what is the speed of same direction? Let me write here. 20 meter per second in same direction. Right? Then velocity of observer, velocity of car with respect to observer, then relative velocity of car, velocity of car as observed by observer is given by velocity of car with respect to observer. Velocity of car with respect to observer. That is velocity of car with respect to ground minus velocity of observer minus velocity of observer with respect to ground. So as per definition we can write this is a vector quantity, so we can write it like this. So velocity of car with respect to ground here, the velocity of car with respect to ground is 20 meter per second. Velocity of observer with respect to ground is 5 meter per second. So we will write here 20 meter per second minus 5, that is 15 meter per second. So observer is observing in this case that car is moving away from it at rate of 15 meter per second. In this case, observer is observing that car is moving away with a speed of 15 meter per second. Right now, considering another one, that velocity. Now consider the velocity of car observer with respect to car. A man sitting in car respect to car is given by velocity of observer with respect to car. That is velocity of observer with respect to ground minus velocity of car with respect to ground. In this case, velocity of observer is 5 meter per second and velocity of car is 20 meter per second. That is minus 15 meter per second. So a man, it means negative velocity. It means a man sitting in car. It means a man sitting in car. A man sitting in car will observe that the observer is moving away from him at rate of 15 meter per second. Negative sign means direction will be opposite. So this is what here the things is approaching. Car is moving in the same direction, that is 15 meter per second, and here person sitting in car will observe that observer is moving away from him at rate of 15 meter per second. Now case 2, third case. Again the same observer consider that observer is moving away. Observer is moving away from car, away from car at rate of 5 meter per second in opposite direction. Of course, away means opposite direction, that is in opposite direction. There was same direction and here is opposite direction. So in that case, the car is, this is the car, and car is moving in this direction at rate of 20 meter per second, and this observer is moving away 5 meter per second. These are the two speeds which is given here. So this is a velocity of observer with respect to ground, that is 5 meter per second. Here velocity of car with respect to ground is 20 meter per second, but this velocity is in negative direction, right? So here velocity of observer, therefore we can write here the velocity of observer, velocity of car with respect to observer, with respect to observer is VCO, velocity of car with respect to observer. Let's write like this, VCO, velocity of car with respect to observer, that is velocity of car with respect to ground minus velocity of observer with respect to ground. But velocity of car is, this is negative velocity, you know. So we will write here velocity of car with respect to ground is 20 and velocity of observer with respect to ground is minus 5. That is 20 plus 5 is 25 meter per second. It means observer will experience that car is moving away from with the speed of 25 meter per second. It means observer is experiencing the speed of car as 25 meter per second away from him. So here the car is moving away with the speed of 25 meter per second. Similarly, if I say the velocity of a man sitting in the car, similarly relative velocity of car, that is a man sitting in car with respect to observer, with respect to car, relative velocity of observer with respect to a man sitting in car or anything respect to with respect to car to car is given by velocity of observer with respect to car. So that is VOG. VOG is equal to velocity of observer minus velocity of car with respect to ground. So in that case, velocity of observer with respect to ground is 5 meter per second and velocity of car with respect to ground is 20 meter per second, that is 25 meter per second. And negative sign shows that car is moving away, that observer is moving away. It means a man sitting in car will observe that man is moving away from him from car with the speed of 25 meter per second. So conclusion, what is conclusion? When two bodies are moving away from each other, their relative velocity is sum of their speeds. Here you can observe that the speed is 20 and this speed is 5. In both the whether car is relative velocity of car with respect to observer or relative velocity of observer with respect to car. In both the cases, it is 25 meter per second. So conclusion is that you can conclusion that when two bodies are moving in opposite direction, their relative velocity, the magnitude of their relative velocity, then the magnitude of their relative velocity, velocity with respect to each other is the sum of magnitudes of both individual bodies, both individual magnitude of individual bodies, magnitude of the speed of individual bodies. Right, this is first. Second conclusion is that when they are moving in same direction, then also when body is moving in same direction, car is also moving in same direction. In that case, their relative velocity when car with respect to observer is 15 and observer with respect to car is also 15. Direction has the different sense, but magnitude is difference of their speeds. Magnitude is difference of their speeds. So second point, when two bodies are moving in same direction, then relative velocities of one body with respect to other, the magnitude of relative velocity of one body with respect to other is given by VAB or VBA. Magnitude is given by, right now, the difference of magnitude of individual speeds. Right. So you can conclude like this. Graphically, now we have a graphical representation. Or we can conclude some other cases as well. Let us consider some more cases and then thereafter we will just discuss the graphical representation. Now there is one more case, third case, say third or fourth, whatever thing is there, fourth case I think so. Suppose a car is, a trolley is moving, or a car is moving, or a train is moving, even accelerator train, anything. A train is, trolley is moving here. This is a trolley, and trolley is moving with the speed of trolley of tractor is moving. Trolley of tractor is, this is a tractor. Here is an engine somewhere. This is an engine, and tractor is moving with the speed of 20 meter per second. And a man here, the man is there on trolley, and he is moving here. He is running with the speed of 5 meter per second. And an observer is sitting here. The third one is observer is sitting here, and he has, observer is stationary. So this is observer A, this is man B, and the trolley is a C. So what is the velocity of observer? Velocity of A observe, velocity of B with respect to A. The velocity of C with respect to A. Here, a relative velocity CT of A, of C with respect to A, is, we have to calculate. And also the relative velocity of B with respect to A. Here it is given that velocity of C with respect to ground is 20 meter per second. Velocity of A with respect to ground is 0. And velocity of B with respect to C is given 5 meter per second, because man is on trolley and trolley is moving, and man is running at a speed of 5 meter per second in same direction. So here, now we have to find velocity of, consider this, we have to find velocity of C with respect to A. So velocity of C with respect to A is nothing else but velocity of C with respect to ground minus velocity of A with respect to ground. So velocity of C with respect to ground is given 20 meter per second minus velocity of A with respect to ground is 0. So that is 20 meter per second. Means what I said earlier, that if a body is moving with the speed of 20 meter per second, then anything which is stationary on the ground, they will observe the relative velocity same as their actual speed, that is 20 meter per second here in this case. Also, relative velocity of C, B as observed by A is what? That is relative velocity of B with respect to ground minus relative velocity of A with respect to ground. But relative velocity of B with respect to ground, we do not know. We know relative velocity of A. We know the relative velocity of, what is that? B with respect to C. So it is given that relative velocity of B with respect to C, it means, is given C. It means relative velocity of B with respect to ground minus relative velocity of C with respect to ground. So relative velocity of B with respect to ground, we don't know, but relative velocity of B with respect to C is 5, and that we do not know. So we write here BC, and that is 20. So relative velocity from this calculation, it is come out, it comes here, relative velocity of B with respect to ground is what? B with respect to ground is, this 20 will come this side, it will be 25 meter per second. So here, if I put this, relative velocity of B with respect to ground is 25 meter per second, this is 0. So 25 meter per second. So velocity of B observed by A is 25 meter per second. And in common sense, what I said earlier, that both the bodies are moving in the same direction, so their relative speed will be sum of their speeds. So 20 plus 5 is 25, and that will be appeared observed. Same direction, the relative velocity of one with respect to another, then it will be difference of their speed. But when it is observed by a stationary object, then relative speed of B with respect to A will be 25 meter per second. Now consider the another case, that trolley is moving but man is running on in opposite direction. Then what will happen? Case 4, right? Now consider this, that trolley is moving opposite direction with respect to trolley. So here what is given, and accordingly we will calculate here, that velocity of B is given with respect to trolley, with respect to C, is, that is what, 5 meter per second. Here velocity of trolley C with respect to ground, that is given as 20 meter per second, but this is a negative one because the direction of these two are opposite. And velocity of A with respect to ground is 0 because he man is stationary. Man is stationary, and these two are moving, one in this direction, another in this direction. So B is moving in this direction, C is moving in this direction, man is stationary, so velocity of that is 0. Velocity of A is 0. Here, velocity of A is 0. Now, we have to observe the velocity of A. What the observer observe the velocity? So we have to observe here the velocity of A. Velocity of C with respect to A is velocity of C with respect to ground minus velocity of A with respect to ground. And that is same as I told you earlier, that because a stationary object will observe the same velocity, relative velocity, as the actual velocity. So this is 20 meter per second. Now the main thing is how B, velocity of B will be observed by A. So velocity of B as observed by A is equal to velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of A with respect to ground. So velocity of B with respect to ground, how you can calculate? Because velocity of B with respect to ground, here again we can calculate velocity of B with respect to ground, can be calculated as velocity of B or with respect to velocity of B with respect to velocity of car. It is given here that velocity of B with respect to C is given. Velocity of B with respect to C is given, that is velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of C with respect to ground. So velocity of B with respect to ground is not known right now, but velocity of B with respect to C is given as minus 5 meter per second, and this is also 20 is given, velocity of C with respect to ground. So velocity of B with respect to ground is 20 minus 5, that is 15. So we can put here velocity of B with respect to ground is 15 minus velocity of A with respect to ground is 0, that is 15 meter per second. So what the velocity of B will A will observe? The velocity of B as 15 meter per second in opposite direction. It means A will experience, it means A will experience the velocity of B, that B is moving away from him, that B is moving, experience that B is moving away from A, with the speed of 15 meter per second. That is what. Now consider one more case that A is also moving. When A is moving, the cart is moving, A is also moving, then what will happen? Suppose A is moving and A is moving with the speed of 5 meter per second, and the man on cart is moving at speed of, and also consider this case as next case 5 or 6, whatever, when man A on ground also moving, is also moving with the speed of 2 meter per second, say 2 meter per second in same direction or opposite direction, right? Direction same and opposite as well, 2 meter per second, right? Man on the track it is C, and C is moving at same, I am taking here 20 meter per second. A man is moving here, that is 5 meter per second in the same direction, and the observer is also moving in the same direction. So what is given here? Try to understand. Here the velocity of A, this person is say A, this one is B, and this one is C. Velocity of A with respect to ground is 2 meter per second. Velocity of B with respect to C is 5 meter per second, and velocity of C with respect to ground is 20 meter per second. Now we have to calculate the velocity of A with C with respect to A. So whenever we have to calculate velocity of C with respect to A, it means velocity of C with respect to ground minus velocity of A with respect to ground. Since both are moving in the same direction, so that is velocity of C with respect to ground is 20, so I'll put 20, and velocity of A with respect to ground is 2, so that will be 18 meter per second. This is the similar case that when two bodies are moving in the same direction, their magnitude of their relative velocity is the difference of their individual magnitudes, that is 20 minus 18 and 2, that is 18 meter per second. So velocity of C as observed by A. Now velocity of B as observed by A is what? That is velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of A with respect to ground. Velocity of B with respect to ground we don't know, because velocity of A with respect to C is given. So here we can conclude that. Let me write here. Make a table. Here velocity, since velocity of B with respect to C is given, that is velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of C with respect to ground is given. Velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of C with respect to ground, that is what given. Here velocity of B with respect to cart or C is given, that 5. And this is velocity of B with respect to ground. This is not given. Velocity of C with respect to ground is given 20. So velocity of B with respect to ground is 20 plus 5, that is 25 meter per second. Now, if I use this value here, then what will happen? Then this will be 25 minus velocity of A with respect to ground is 2, that is 23 meter per second. So velocity of B as experienced by A, therefore velocity of B as experienced by A, is 23 meter per second. Moving away is 23 meter per second, moving away from him, moving away from him, right? And velocity of C is, velocity of C is as experienced by A, is what? 18 meter per second moving away from him. I hope you got this all points. Similarly, if they are in opposite direction, you can calculate it. There will be no problem, I think so. And you'll be able to get all these things. That you have to apply every time. And you have to take care of all these things, right? So, hopefully you will do it. And after the break, we will discuss some more questions and more graphical solutions as well, graphs of this relative motions. Take care and have a break now. God bless you.